थर्ड वन इज कल्चरल एनवायरमेंट. इट्स वेरी अगेन क्रॉस कल्चरलिज्म. कल्चरल एनवायरमेंट विल बी फॉर्म्ड बिकॉज ऑफ मूविंग ऑफ वन कंट्री, मूविंग फ्रॉम वन कंट्री टू अनदर कंट्री. डेफिनेटली ऑन साइड जॉब्स, ऑफ साइड जॉब्स, डेफिनेटली दैट विल बी कल्चरल एनवायरमेंट इज वन ऑफ द क्रिटिकल कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ देयर इंटरनेशनल बिजनेस एनवायरमेंट एंड वन ऑफ द मोस्ट डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. सी व्हेन मेनी मेनी कल्चर्ड पीपल आर कमिंग टू वन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दे आर वर्किंग फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर विजन ऑफ दैट और विजन और मिशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. डेफिनेटली देर विल बी अ काइंड ऑफ क्लैशेस, ग्रुपिज्म, वॉट वी कैन कॉल अ लॉट ऑफ एच आर इश्यूज विल फॉर्म, राइट. सो हैंडलिंग दैम विल बी वेरी वेरी डिफिकल्ट. द पॉलिसीज, प्रोसीजर्स फेवरिंग वन कल्चर पीपल मे नॉट satisfy the another other set of people. So that this is because of the cultural environment is essentially unseen. It has been described as shared, commonly held body of general belief and values that determine what is right for one group according to Clicquot and Strawback. National culture is described as the body of general benefits and the values that are shared by the nation. Beliefs and the values are generally seen as formed by such factors such as the history, language, religion, geographical location, government and education. Thus, firms begin a cultural analysis by seeking to understand these factors. The most well-known is the developed by the Hofstede in 1980s. Hofstede model proposes four dimensions of cultural values, including individualism, uncertainty, avoidance, power, distance, and masculinity. So his model proposes mainly cultural values, including individualism. Right, giving importance to a particular person or the individual, uncertainty, avoidance, power distance and masculinity. Individualism is the degree to which a nation values and encourages individual action and decision making. Uncertainty, avoidance is the degree to which nation is willing to accept or deal with the uncertainty. Power distance is the degree to which national accepts and sanctions differences in the power. This model of cultural values has been used extensively because it provides data for a wide array of countries. Many academics and the managers found that this model helpful in exploring management approaches that would be appropriate in different culture. For example, in a nation that is high on individualism, on accepts individual goals, individual tasks, individual reward systems to be effective, whereas the reverse would be the case in a nation that is low in individualism. So it is all country policies whether these things can be dealt with individually or it should be handled in the group. So cultural factors are very important in dealing with the organizational culture. It is really challenging to an HR manager to understand each and everyone's requirement, and the policies also should be made to satisfy each and every employees of the organization. While analyzing social and cultural factors, the organization may consider the following aspects: approaches to society towards business in general and in specific areas, influence of social, cultural, religious factors on the acceptability of the product. So they have to decide it. The lifestyle of people and the products used for them, level of acceptance of or resistance to change. Acceptance means considering the or they are able to accept the changes, or they may resist to change. They may oppose to change. Values attached to a particular product, the possessive value or the functional value of the product. This should be very, it will be very challenging to handle actually, whether it is a possessive value or the functional value of the product. Demand for the specific products for special or specific occasions. The propensity to consume and to save. Everything is different for different people. So company or organizational culture has to be tackled using all these kind of areas, or specifically we have to give the importance to understand each and every point what we are discussing here. The competitive environment, cultural environment, then it is competitive environment. The competitive environment also changes from country to country, right? This is partly because of the economic, political, cultural and environments. These environmental factors help determine the type and degree of competition that exists in the given country. Aggressiveness. Some countries are very aggressive in adopting new things, right? But some countries are very passive. Slowly, they will be watchful, but they won't adopt it. If a new invention happened, and a new product came to the market, the customers will be of different kinds, right? Some are aggressive to purchase the new one. Some are always testing the new things. Some are passive to text. Some are always wait. Okay, after 6 months, let us see how it performs. These things, it is part of the competition. Degree of competition that exists in that country. Competition can come from a variety of sources. It can be a public or a private sector, come from the larger or smaller organization, be domestic or global, stemming from traditional or new competitors. Sorry, by mistake it is GST registration is here. No need of giving importance to this particular words. GST registration nowhere linked here. It is a manual error. So competition can come from variety of sources. Source of competition can be from anywhere. It can be public or private sector, right? Sometimes public companies are aggressive than the private sector. Governments are very aggressive than the private sector. It may be large or smaller industries, or it can be domestic or global, or it may be a completely new competitor, or sometimes it may be from the traditional players. For domestic firm, the most likely the sources of competition might be well understood. The same is not in the case when a person moves to compete in the newer environment, right? Hope you understood this slide. A demographic and economic development environment. In recent times or in the modern era, the demographic problem has gained strength and has been consolidated in public opinion. The media and the different social agents are very aware that this is one of the great challenges facing our society. Every day we hear and read news and articles related to this phenomenon. As is well known, demography studies those processes that determine the formation, conservation and disappearance of populations. It is study of population in a particular in a geographical area, the literacy level, the gender level, the cultural aspects, religious factors, everything we are studying in demographic. Taste and trends will different for different demographic areas. Such processes in their aggregate form are those of fertility, mortality and mobility. The variety of combination of these phenomena determines the degree of changes in the population, both in its numerical dimension and in its structure. This is highlighted by Levi Baxey in 1993. So death rate, fertility. Third one is the economic dynamism, subjective well-being, the outcrop of new brains, the persistence of cultural identity, the hustle and bustle of vibrant towns and villages, the strength of social capital and civil society. Economic dynamism, dynamic nature, the what we find in economy, the subjective well-being, people should be subjective to be good, the outcrop of new brains, new people, the persistence of cultural identity. Yes, my culture is great, I have to follow this kind of things. The hustle and bustle of vibrant towns and villages, the strength of social capital and the civil society, all are important factors of a demographic environment. Just to see this slide here, we are giving some directions for demographic environment. Changing age structure of the population, right? Whether a selected area has more old people or experienced people or retired people, changing household patterns, if it is changing our transition state, village is transition state to become an urban area. So here structure of houses will be as per the modern system. Geographic shifts in the population, better educated, more white collar, more professional population, increasing diversity, right? Because of other people are migrating here. Demographics is about the characteristics of the population in a specific area and includes multiple factors like age, race, income, etc. Further, most businesses find the data with respect to these factors within the targeted demographic variable of the interest, as it can affect the growth and the success of a business. So each and every aspect of people in that particular population in a selected area, you have to target the age factors, race factors, income factors, gender factor, literacy factor, infrastructure factor, everything, living standard, cultural factors, religious factors, traits and trends, beliefs, everything is part of the demography. So it affects the growth and the success of a business. For example, India has around 16% of the world's population and is second to China. Also, India has a relatively younger population compared to China. Therefore, many international companies are targeting India as a potential market for various products and services.